Fool enough to be her dad. But the young men were just mad. They nursed their grievances. But she was flattered by his charm. It wouldn't do her any harm. They'd all had their chances. You sent her flowers and limousines, and she was treated like a queen. And anything she ever wanted was no problem for a man like him. And everyone expected soon that she could ask him for the moon if she would wear his ring. Knowing glances from his friends in the homes at the weekends of high society. But at one degree's removal, what he'd lost in their approval, he made up all with a certain notoriety. But their wives had colder glances, they'd a name for such romances, and they'd confer on all the faults that they were picking. But he didn't give a damn, he'd never felt more like a man, but all the time the clock was ticking. All would envy the older man and his beautiful young wife. All would envy. Never what it seemed to all the old friends she'd ignored. She denied that she was bored. She had no time for dancing, no time for dancing. But the clock upon the wall, this ticking in the hall, always reminded her life was going on elsewhere. But she was happy and she swore she wouldn't change a thing. Again with that old friend of hers. She loves to dance. She's missing more and more these days. I'm still stuck in my old ways. Perhaps she needs a little more romance. But the clock upon the wall, ever ticking in the hall, she must be home soon. Where a younger man would weep, he takes a pill and goes to sleep.